reduction of perceived stress, anxiety, depression, and even the ejection fraction improved. And this is the largest study again reported from India. Again, this was a late-breaking trial in American Heart Association meeting, and I am one of the authors in that. Dr. Prabhakar presented. This is 26 centers in India, 4,000 patients who had angioplasty done with a stent. Half of them were followed with the yoga and half were followed by the conventional therapy. And it was found that there was a improved quality of life and there was a tendency towards less events. Of course, the follow-up is short, it's being followed up. But this is again the largest study which has been reported. It was accepted as a late-breaking trial in American Heart Association, which rarely takes these Indian studies. So I think the current science is really paying attention to this methods and all. What about heart failure? A few studies are there, and this is again a large study which is being initiated now in several centers, same 40 centers, that the small studies show that ejection fraction can improve. It can improve the oxygen consumption and quality of life. And the reason is because, as I show you, yoga reverses all the abnormal pathophysiological pathways of heart failure and all. So there's a lot of potentiality in heart failure, and a large study is going to start. As I say, it is now picking up in the so-called conventional medicine. This is a huge article which came in American Heart Journal a couple of years back, that meditation and cardiovascular risk reduction is scientific statement from the American Heart. And also they came to the conclusion that it seems to be useful for prevention of heart disease. Of course, the studies are not very strong. We need stronger evidence, but they also came to the conclusion now, and they are getting interested into this. Now, what is the mechanism? This is again a very intriguing thing. We do not know the exact mechanism, but people have studied, tried to study it, that during meditation there is a change in the MRI, the functional MRI imaging of the brain. Those areas are stimulated where we have concentration, and those areas there is a less concentration in those where we have ego and jealousy and hostility. And also functional MRI imaging has been done, even neurochemicals have been shown, as I was showing you, the dopamine and the other things. The serotonin have been shown to increase with this. So there is a neural part of it. Also shows that it reduces psychosocial stress. And you know, depression is a very strong factor after myocardial infarction, after heart failure. If a person is severely depressed, the chances of death increase about 50 to 100%. So psychosocial stress reducing after this could be very useful. It also shown that it reduces the allostatic load by increasing the activity of the parasympathetic nervous system and GABA system. Optimal homeostasis is achieved. It has also been shown to act through four interconnected pathways. You see, when we do yoga, there are four pathways which are, one is the stress is reduced, sympathetic system is reduced, which causes reduced atherosclerosis and so on. On the other side, vagal stimulation occurs because of pranayama, etc., which can also change the heart rate variability, and they interact in a way that oxidative stress, endothelial function is reduced. Number of studies available. The third pathway is that there is a changes in the brain structure and function. It has been shown that the brain can grow. This was not known for a long period of time. People were meditating, their brain size and structure and function can improve. And then fourth pathway is a physical exercise. So it can act through all these pathways. Also, inflammatory markers have been shown to be decreased, and these are very important for causation of heart disease and other diseases. Like studies have been done, IL-6, CRP, TNF-alpha, and endothelial function shown by adenopectin is reduced. It also been shown to oxidative stress. It may also affect the gene expression. It has been shown by Dean Ornish that 26 genes can be prevented, or the expression can be prevented with this. And of course, there are studies on telomere length also. This is the only method which can possibly give us longevity. And telomere length, there are four papers, including from All India Institute of Medical Sciences, that yoga can modify these telomere lengths, which affect the aging. Of course, the limitations of these yoga studies, you must understand this. Although they have demonstrated beneficial effects, but there are many limitations. Most studies are single center, a small sample size, and non-uniform methodology. These are many studies are non-randomized, although more and more RCTs are coming. The follow-up period is short and clinical endpoints are lacking. So such studies, we need to see the hard clinical endpoints, and multicentral studies are needed. And as I said, India is taking the lead in diabetes, in post-angioplasty we have taken, and in obesity. I think India is taking the lead into this, but there is a need for other things also. So to conclude, yoga is a holistic mind-body technique which appears extremely promising for wellness, positive health and prevention of non-communicable, almost all diseases. Reported studies have limitations, large centers are needed. However, yoga being a simple, cost-effective technique, no side effects could be incorporated. To conclude, I would consider yoga as a super medicine because it is equivalent to, it is an antidepressant and anxiolytic. It is anti-hypertensive, as I have shown you, mild, although the modest degrees. It is also anti-diabetic, as you saw several studies. Anti-arrhythmic also, both ventricular and atrial fibrillation. Decongestive, it could be helpful in heart failure. Anti-inflammatory, may regress atherosclerosis. Anti-asthmatic, you heard for that. It may be useful for GI disorders. It may be useful for wellness and positive health. And it is cost-effective without side effects. I don't know of any medicine which has so many effects, is free and has no side effects. Of course, we need more studies, and I will like all the young people to get involved into this mind-body, because I think this is the future of medicine. Thank you very much for your time.
Thank you so much, sir. If anybody is having queries regarding this topic, can ask, sir.
Thank you, Dr. Manjanda. First of all, I must compliment you that being a professor of cardiology, talking so much and so nicely about yoga. It's a matter of great pleasure. My question to you is only one. If yoga is that much important for the health, and yoga is that much taking care of all the coming up illnesses, why the government of India should not make a subject right from the schooling as yoga?
Yeah, this question is very common, why it's not that popular. The reason is, you see, it is not backed by pharmaceutical industry. Firstly, is that there are no large studies and there's no advertisement going on. Our Prime Minister has done a lot. He has made this in compulsory in almost all schools, but schools are not giving much importance. Even in the hospitals, my friend Dr. In Subdering Government Hospital, there's a yoga thing, but hardly anybody is referring. The biggest problem is the modern day physicians, the medical people have not accepted this. And this is because, I think, because of lack of knowledge. That's why I've said in the undergraduate, postgraduate, we should give some data on what is available with this. It's extremely useful. I think it is going to come very soon. You will see that United States and India is doing a lot of research into this. And I was told in United States, Dr. Satbir Khalsa, who is in Harvard, that they are trying to make it compulsory in schools in United States because they have shown it so beneficial. I think in our country also it is there. Any hospital can have it. There's a big department. You can have a center of yoga. They will do it free. Only thing is, we should be referring patients there. You see, we medical professionals have not taken it up because the reason is simple. They are not even aware what yoga. Practice. You can combine it with anything. You can combine it with drugs. It will have better effect. And if drugs are not there, it's very useful for primary prevention also. So I think the lack of knowledge is there. And secondly, of course, we need more randomized multicentral trials. As I said, studies have their weaknesses. These are not very, very strong studies. And this is what American Heart Association also said. But I am sure in the near future, as more and more randomized controlled multicentral trials are going with a long-term follow-up, it will be acceptable. It has a lot of potential. As I said, it is potential. But I think I am using it for my patients for the last 25 years. All patients who have angioplasty, bypass, or who have mild disease, 40%, what do you do? I put them into yoga and I have found tremendous good results. And we have published this also. I think what we need is the scientists, the doctors have to take up this as research. Only then it will be popular. And it's very easy to do research. You can take up 100 cases of hypertension, ambulatory blood pressure, you can take diabetes, you can take obesity, you can take osteoarthritis, you can take anything you know of, but you have to do a randomized controlled trial. And once you do it, as some centers are doing it, American Diabetic Association is giving it most importance. We were given importance in American Heart Association. I think we have to do more research. Awareness has to be there. It has a bright future. At present, it's not there in the limelight. It's not in the conventional medicine, but I'm sure it's going to take over.
Sir, one thing. Playing games versus yoga and fast walking versus yoga, what is your opinion about it? Playing games, that is also meditation also along with that. We are having in game, playing.
I got it correctly, so what is the difference between brisk walking and yoga? That's what we say. Yoga is not an exercise, I must tell you, although if you do certain type of yoga, it can be mild to moderate exercise. So exercise useful, we all know that. So physical exercise should be a part of your routine. I said four things in your life, in your lifestyle. The one is the diet, which comes in. Even exercise is a part of yoga. If you say Ramdev has made some exercise, you can stationary jogging, you can do that. That is also important. And the third most important, that's what yoga is all about. You think positive, concentrate on one thing at a time and think positive, that's all. And don't be affected by ups and downs. Many times angioplasty is a failure. Many times you treat a patient is a failure. Don't get upset, you try to do your best. So what happens is, we are doing for a short period. This makes your attitude change. So it has to be a change of attitude. 1 hour doing yoga means nothing. Ultimately, people ask me, I said it should be 24 hours. While somebody is talking to you, he's abusing you, are not talking rightly, if you don't get angry, that is yoga. If you are walking, you can do yoga, concentrate on walking. Don't discuss politics, but mostly when you are eating your food, you can do yoga meditation. Concentrate on food, don't concentrate on TV or discussing the politics. That's what it is. So it becomes a yogic attitude. I agree, exercise, yes, angioplasty, yes. You have a serious patient, you don't think of anything else. So this is what we are trying to say. When you are doing anything, just concentrate, forget everything else. That's what yoga is.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for an enlightening talk. So it is really a pleasure to host you in Bathinda, sir.